Hi, this is Lynn from the Humber Arboretum. Today I'm going to talk about the American robin. The interesting thing about American robins is that they are actually not really robins. They are thrushes. They were given the name robin when the first settlers came from England to North America and saw them because they do have a slight resemblance to the English robin. And I guess the settlers were homesick. In the Ojibwe language, the robin is called Opachi, and Opachi is considered to be the messenger of the morning, announcing the arrival of Wabanung, which is the new dawn every day. This is a teaching that I received from Jim Dumont, Anabinase. Robins are a grayish-brown, medium-sized bird with a reddish-orange breast and a white patch under their tail. The head is a little bit darker gray, and they do have a white eye ring. The females are a little bit paler than that, but they look very similar to the males. The juveniles, however, they have a speckled orange breast. When they are fledged and out with their parents, they're the same size as the adults. There is a similar looking species called the Eastern Towhee, and although it exists in similar habitats and shares similar foods, it is not as common as the robin, and robins are so much more common that it is unlikely that you would mistake them for any other species. There's an American robin singing way at the top of this maple tree this morning. They sing to declare their territory. So he's up there declaring his territory in our neighborhood. It's a very sing-songy call. Cheerio, cheerio, cheery. And it sounds like there's another one in the neighborhood answering him. That's their territory sound. They also make a scolding call if they get annoyed or disturbed. And it's more of a high-pitched tuck, tuck, tuck. But right now he's just singing for the morning, greeting the day.
Robins are omnivores. Depending on the season, they will eat invertebrates and Other seasons, they'll eat fruits and berries. In the spring and early summer, they tend to feed mainly on invertebrates, and you'll often see them hopping along a lawn and stopping abruptly, tilting their head and pulling out an earthworm from the soil. They'll also feast on earthworms after a rain when the earthworms are brought to the surface. As well as earthworms, they will eat other insects and sometimes snails. However, by late fall, when they are no longer in their breeding season, they will start to gather. They gather in flocks before they migrate, and at that time they tend to feed more likely on berries and fruits. So they'll see them eating grapes or choke cherries or hawthorn berries and sumac berries on their way before they leave to migrate south. Robins originally nested in forests. However, they're very adaptable. The first nest is built usually in May in an evergreen where they have good shelter. And then the second, they usually have two broods, and the second nest is usually built later on in the summer in a deciduous tree. However, with the increasing urban development and rural development, they've also been very adaptable, and they can build on windowsills, ledges, and any structure that will support a nest. You can see right here, this is a carport, and the nest has been built in this support. It's a great location because it is sheltered from the weather, protected from the wind, and is a very stable structure. You can see the nest has got a lot of mud in it. It is a cup-shaped nest with grass woven into the mud. And then the inside, there are some smaller needles or soft grasses.
Robins lay 3 to 5 blue-green eggs in their cup-shaped nest that is reinforced with mud. They incubate those eggs for approximately 2 weeks. Both parents take turns sitting on the nest. And then after the eggs hatched, the nestlings remain in the nest for another 2 weeks before they fledge and fly out of the nest. Once they fledge, they do not return to the nest. Fledglings will remain with the parents for another month or so, following them around, perfecting their flight, and learning where they can find food. An average lifespan of a robin is approximately 2 years, however, the eggs that are laid, of all the eggs that are laid each year, only about 25% of those actually grow up and survive through their first year. A visit to the Humber Arboretum will often reveal the robins in the fields and the meadows and on our lawns. You'll probably see them running along, stopping abruptly, tilting their head and pulling out an earthworm to feed themselves or their young throughout the summer.